Who'd be stupid enough to quit their six-figure tech sales job in Dublin, move to the other side of the world, in Sydney, and start a brand new business from scratch? Right here. It's a beautiful Thursday morning here in Sydney. I said beautiful. I kind of lied. It's going to be a really nice day. Been a really good, productive week so far this week. About to head to the gym. We've got a push day on the cards. Going to film a little bit in the gym, but that's not the real point of today's video. We've got some exciting updates. I just have a good feeling it's going to be a good day. We're moving in the right direction. If you're watching this video right now, like right now, drop it a like. Give a comment. Just say hello in the comments. And if you don't, that's okay too, but I'd appreciate it if you did. Just sitting on the bench, sipping my pre-workout. I don't know if you guys drink Ghost. I recommended it to one of the lads from my old job. He was like, Sean, do you recommend any pre-workouts? I was like, yep. He sent me a picture last night. On the back of Ghost, there's a warning that says, this substance may expose you to chemicals that cause cancer. I've been taking this stuff for years.
It's not great, is it?
But hey, look, cancer aside, I love Ghost. Also, sorry, I acknowledge how ridiculous this looks. I look like a fighter pilot right now. So just call me Maverick or call me Rooster, whichever one you prefer. Might just rename the channel. Let's go with Rooster. Rooster. I got composite bonding done about 3 years ago, 2.5 years ago at this stage. So I have to wear this little gum shield now when I'm in the gym because I chipped one of my teeth like a month after getting it. As you may or may not know, I make some pretty extreme faces when I'm lifting. So I paid too much money to have these chipped again. So gum shield it is. We've got a brand deal, folks. We've got a brand deal. First one back, we're happy about it. So do me a favor, click the link in the bio when I tell you what it is. Let's show we've built a solid little community here that can actually get behind and support and be beneficial to a business. I would really appreciate it. It would mean a lot. Okay, hello. So today's video is sponsored by Lumon. Get a lot of questions, particularly on Instagram, about how I style my hair. Shaved, had a shower, wash my hair. This is how it would typically be sitting right after I get out of the shower. So what I'm gonna do is show you how I'd style it using the Lumon products. I've been using these for about a week and a half now at this stage. Really like them. Been using two products mainly, which is the Ascend Volume Cream and Heat Protector as a pre-styler, and second, styling my hair and kind of keeping it in place with the Cavalier Heavy Clay. First things first, I'm gonna towel dry it a little bit. Towel dry it and try and put it in somewhat of a shape. It's the Ascend Volume Cream. So you're gonna put about that much through your hair to start off. You can see my hair is already starting to take shape. Take your trusty hair dryer and blow dry your hair. So this is how it's looking right now. Just needs a little bit of product to finish it off. Cavalier Heavy Clay. This is actually really, really nice in the hair. So rub it all in, get it in there. Always make sure to pull this bit forward to protect the receding hairline. That is the finished product, folks. So thank you very much to Blue Man. We've got a 10% discount for anybody who uses code Sean. It's gonna be the first link down in the bio. Get 10% off the products. I would recommend the Ascend Volume Cream as a pre-styler, Cavalier Heavy Clay as your two kind of products to go to, especially if you have hair that's in any way similar to mine. Really good hold, lasts all day, smells great. Let's get back to the video.
Okay, so let's address the topic of today's video. The title of the video, the reason you're probably watching right now, it's why I left my six-figure sales job to pursue my passion and ultimately move across the other side of the world to Australia. First things first, not answering to anybody in an office environment, not having a boss and not making money for somebody else and actually just making money for myself. Something I've always been passionate about, I guess. Enjoy the idea of the work that I'm doing being beneficial to me in a selfish sense. I got a little bit frustrated and unhappy with the idea of doing all this work. And don't get me wrong, being well rewarded for it financially, but it was ultimately making money for somebody else and increasing the value of someone else's company rather than putting into my own effort and my own venture, which I'd always had in the back of my mind. Yeah, that was definitely a big part of it. And that's being pretty honest. I don't know how many people would say that to you, but yeah. One of the big reasons why I did what I did was being able to work for myself, building something for myself rather than just being a cog in the machine of a much bigger company like Salesforce or like Stripe, who were my previous employers.
I wasn't happy in my role. And, you know, money was great. On paper, everything looked really good. I was living in a nice apartment with one of my best friends from childhood. Expensive, good, Dublin, cool part of the city to live. Going out every Saturday night, money in the pocket. On paper, really good life, you know, career going well, career progression is there. It's like, you've got a good CV now, you've got Salesforce and you've got Stripe on your CV at 27. You know, like on paper, things are looking good. I just wasn't happy. I didn't love going into the office, as a lot of my friends will know from the old job. Yeah, I wasn't happy in the role. I didn't feel like it pushed me in any way. Like I knew I could do it. You know, it's sales, it's not rocket science. It's just kind of a little bit of be chatty and be a little bit persistent with people, and you're probably gonna get on quite well in sales. So yeah, I guess I always felt like there was a little bit more to life than just working a 9-to-5 job in an office. I didn't know that I felt like that until I had gone and done it for 5 years and realized, no, hang on, this isn't the way. I suppose for context, it's important to know too, I did this coaching and this kind of social media stuff during college. And immediately after coming out of college, I was like, okay, coaching is my job now, I'm gonna do this. And I stopped because I didn't want to be sat at home all day, every day, on my own, in the house, while my mom and dad went to work, while my sister was in school. I was like, geez, this is really boring. But then I was like, right, well, I've used the last 4 years of my life to go get a degree, I may as well put it to use. So I did, tried that for 5 years, just to find out that that's not what I actually wanted to do. And it made me appreciate the freedom of working for myself, work from anywhere culture. So, yeah. Does that make sense? Hope so. I could go on a lot more, into a hell of a lot more detail about this and into what ultimately kind of shaped this decision and stuff. But final one that I want to touch on for today, one of the most important factors really was my passion. It's become clear to me over the last few years that the gym truly is my passion. I mentioned this in my TikTok that I created as well, that, you know, I almost tried to deny it for a little while to say that the gym wasn't my passion because I had made this decision originally to move away from it. I was trying to trick myself mentally to say, no, I've still made the right decision. I don't regret it, even though I knew deep down I did. The gym is undoubtedly my passion. And I don't think everybody in life finds their passion, as corny as that sounds, right? And if you've been watching me for a while, or if you know me, even know I hate the corny stuff, so please don't take that as corny. But I do think I'm in a fortunate position whereby I had a following, I moved away from it, realized, oh, maybe I made a mistake, I can go back to it because that is my passion. Not everybody's in that position. And I figured I didn't want to be in my 80s, hopefully my 90s, maybe even 100, on my deathbed thinking, what if? I took a risk, and at the minute, financially, it's hurting. You know, I can't lie. Like, you know, starting a new business from scratch, moving country, like there's a hell of a lot of cost involved with that. Financially, it's not a great decision right now. But I think in the long term, if YouTube picks up, coaching continues going the way it's going, like I have to say the coaching has actually surprised me with how well it's done. I did expect, like, just so people aren't like, this guy's an idiot, I did expect to take a massive financial hit doing this. But I think in the long run, I've prioritized my happiness, I've prioritized my passion, and I've prioritized not having any regrets moving forward. Look, if it doesn't work out, which I'm completely aware is a very possible and realistic scenario, I'll say okay, and I'll go back. I'll find a job. I'll do something. But I'd much rather know than not know. God, that sounds dramatic. But yeah, they're kind of the three main reasons as to why I've done what I did. I've done what I did. Is that even the right way to say it? Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, look, if you're still here and you're still watching, you've enjoyed the video, do me a favor, give it a like. Subscribe if you're new. I'm getting back into the habit of this YouTube thing and into the kind of creative process behind it again. I'm really enjoying the style that I have going right now. I really hope that you are too. Got a couple ideas for coming videos too. So we're all on the up. First brand deal. Crazy. Please, as I said earlier, give that a little bit of support. I will see you all very soon. Cheers.
I might start doing a blooper section at the end of videos. That's gonna sound so loud in that too.
Not quite what I was thinking, but. You do you, man. I'm a go.
Can't imagine why.
See you later, man.
Bye, Dano.